subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. In the yogic culture, Lord Shiva is seen as first guru and is therefore called Adi Guru. The relationship between a teacher and a student is considered most sacred, not just in Hinduism, but in all the cultures. This pious bond between a guru and a shishya is celebrated in the form of Guru Purnima by Hindus, Jains and Buddhists every year. In this episode of My India, let's have a look how the country celebrated the festival this year amid the worldwide pandemic. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwara, Gurur Sakshat, Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha. This famous quote by Upmanyu defines that Guru or teacher is more sacred than all the gods and divine energies in this universe. Each year, the festival of Guru Purnima is celebrated on the 5th of July to commemorate this sacred bond and mark the importance of all those who act as guiding light for others. This year, amid the COVID-19 pandemic, this festival was celebrated round the country with peace and harmony, along with proper adherence to social distancing norms.
हम लोगों की त्याग तपस्या राष्ट्र के लिए है। राष्ट्र सुखी हो, राष्ट्र के सभी लोग सुखी हो, समृद्धशाली हो, और ये महामारी बहुत जल्दी से जल्दी खत्म हो।
Said to be among the holiest cities of India, Varanasi is known for celebrating most of the Hindu festivals with grandeur and frolic. The ghats of the city are thronged by devotees on various occasions every year, Guru Purnima being one of them. Each year, people visit their spiritual gurus to seek their blessings on this auspicious occasion and take a dip on the ghats of Banaras. But this year, amid the COVID-19 pandemic, very few devotees were seen taking holy dip at the river Ganges and instead decided to celebrate the festival at their homes harmoniously.
भीड़ नहीं है ना।
हाँ, अपने
घर में ये तो नदी में स्नान करेगा, चल जाएगा, सुबह सुबह कर को चल जाएगा। आज महात्मा लोग सब लोग ने मुंडन करना पड़ेगा।
द सिटी ऑफ मथुरा सेलिब्रेट्स द फेस्टिवल इन द फॉर्म ऑफ मुदिया मेला विच स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम द शाइनी एकादशी अ नाइट बिफोर द फुल मून ऑफ गुरु पूर्णिमा। But this year, amid the worldwide pandemic, This famous mela was cancelled by the authorities. However, the priests made sure to carry out the Mudiya Shobha Yatra, which is a religious procession to mark the festival. The procession consists of musical instruments and devotees dancing on the melodious tunes as they walk the roads to mark their dedication towards their gurus and the gods.
महामारी वैश्विक महामारी के कारण ये मेला इस बार स्थगित किया गया, लेकिन जो परंपरागत जो रूप है उसी रूप से हम इस बार भी इस मुड़िया शोभा यात्रा को प्रारंभ किए हैं। जो हर साल की भांति इस बार भी इस परंपरा को हम निभा रहे हैं।
The festival is celebrated on the full moon day in the Hindu month of Ashad, which coincides with the Gregorian month of June and July, and therefore is known as Ashad Purnima. The festival was revived by Mahatma Gandhi to pay tribute to his spiritual guru Srimad Rajchandra, and is also known as Vyas Purnima, as it marks the birthday of Ved Vyas, who was a spiritual guru and the author of ancient Hindu texts like Vedas, Puranas and the epic Mahabharat. Having compassion for all and holding equal regards for each other's beliefs. This is what the Indian tradition has taught us for ages, which is still being followed. A glimpse of it was recently witnessed when the pilgrims of Amarnath Yatra reached Anantnag district of Jammu and Kashmir for maize procession, and people of different faiths came forward to attend the rituals that are performed at its beginning. Have a look.
Amidst the holy chants of Vedic hymns, a ritualistic ceremony was performed at a temple in Pahalgam town of Anantnag district in Jammu and Kashmir before the famed religious maize procession or Chhadi Mubarak Yatra. As per traditions, throughout the journey, the maize travels with saints and devotees for 46 kilometers through Pahalgam, Chandanwadi, Sheshnag and Panchtarni to the final destination of Amarnath Holy Cave Shrine, which is believed to be the abode of Lord Shiva. Though this year, amid COVID-19 pandemic, a huge gathering was not witnessed as it used to be there in previous years, but still the brotherhood among the Hindus and Muslims was not missed as they came together to perform these special rituals.
इसमें तो पूरा सभी तबकों का रोल रहता है, चाहे मुस्लिम हो, हिंदू हो, सिख हो, जो भी हो, हर एक इसमें तो हर एक मज़हब से रखने देना, मज़हब के लोग इसमें शमूलियत करते
हैं। ये जो पूजा हो रही है यहाँ पर, जिसमें हमारे साधु बाबा जो है वो यहाँ पर आए हैं, लेकिन इससे पहले जब पूजा होती थी यहाँ पे इस टाइम में तो बहुत भीड़ रहती थी, जिसमें यहाँ के जितने भी लोकल जो होते थे, चाहे वो मुसलमान हो या जो हमारे कश्मीरी पंडित भाई है, वो आते थे यहाँ पर। लेकिन आज आपको पता ही है कि ये जो महामारी है, बीमारी की वजह से कोई यहाँ पर आ नहीं पाया, इसके लिए हमें बहुत ही अफसोस है। और आज जो यहाँ पर पूजा हुई है बहुत ही सक्सेसफुल हुई है, लेकिन वो गैदरिंग देखी नहीं गई।
For ages, local Muslims and Hindu pilgrims are celebrating this occasion collectively with religious fervor. This year, as devotees could not come in large numbers, all the rituals were performed accordingly by priests, who even asked the people across the country to adhere to social distancing norms and follow all guidelines issued by the government.
प्रार्थना से काम नहीं होगा, अब हमें संयम भी करना पड़ेगा। और जो राज्य सरकार जिस तरह से कि निर्धारण करती है व्यवस्था, जैसे अब कैलिब्रेटेड वे से दुकानें खुल रही हैं, एक दिन एक पक्ष खुलेगा, दूसरे दिन दूसरा खुलेगा, आपने मास्क लगाना है, आपने सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग करनी है, तो कई जगह कहते हैं कि ये कभी कभी धर्म की रक्षा के लिए शास्त्र पर्याप्त नहीं होता है, शस्त्र की जरूरत पड़ती है। तो आज ये जो मास्क है ये शस्त्र है।
Attended by the people of various faiths, Chhadi Mubarak plays an important role in espousing communal harmony among various communities and display the true picture of India's unity in diversity.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
People who recovered from coronavirus infections in New Delhi are donating plasma for the treatment for patients who are suffering from a deadly disease in the national capital. Donors have been donating plasma at the newly inaugurated plasma bank at the state-run Institute of Liver and Biliary Sciences Hospital for treatment of patients suffering from the respiratory disease. Chief Minister of Delhi Arvind Kejriwal inaugurated this India's first plasma bank few days back with an effort to save the lives of critical COVID-19 patients in the city.
When I received a call from somebody who works in this hospital, उन्होंने भी जब मुझसे पूछा कि आप क्या प्लाज्मा डोनेट करना चाहेंगे, and my mother was like, हाँ हाँ तुम करो, क्योंकि अच्छा है कि किसी की जान बचेगी। इतने लोग, because each and every day so many people are dying and there are so many cases and there is no cure till now. And what I feel is we cannot wait until a cure has been released. पर हमको ये बात की ज़्यादा देखना चाहिए कि अभी हमारे पास जो चीज़ है हम उससे कैसे help कर सकते हैं किसी की।
While the degree of effectiveness of plasma as a coronavirus treatment remains unclear, the Indian Health Ministry is allowing it to be used and gathered at blood banks under certain conditions, while the global pharma industry is working to develop antibody-based therapies.
For the very first time in history, Aarti at Amarnath Cave in Himalayas is getting live streamed to devotees. The Amarnath Shrine Board has made special arrangements for the live telecast of the Aarti and Darshan of Lord Amarnath, which is being telecast on Doordarshan. Devotees who were watching the Aarti at their homes were effusive in their praise of Shrine Board for taking such a step.
ये श्राइन बोर्ड ने बहुत अच्छा किया कि हमें मतलब सुबह सुबह मौका मिला हमें आरती देखने का लाइव, तो हमें बहुत अच्छा लगा।
The decision came in the wake of COVID-19 pandemic, due to which the Jammu and Kashmir government has put several restrictions on Amarnath pilgrimage this year.
World's largest temporary hospital with 10,000 bed capacity for COVID-19 patients was inaugurated in the national capital. To tackle the surge, the Delhi government is trying to increase the capacity of beds by transforming spiritual center into a temporary hospital.
This is a very good facility. This facility contains 10% of the bedded, oxygenated bedded. In case any patient requires oxygen, we are able to give them. We have specialists of all. We have counselors for mentally stressed cases, traumatic cases. The very fear of corona creates sometimes stress among the people. So we have a team of good counselors, psychiatrists, specialists in medicine, and all spheres who will be needed here.
The hospital was inaugurated by Lieutenant Governor of Delhi Anil Baijal, and it will take care of patients coming from Delhi and National Capital Region. Apart from arranging counselors for mentally traumatic cases, the patients can also play games and read books while getting treatment in the center.
A group of engineers in Chennai have come with a technology that will act as a bridge between COVID-19 patients and health workers. Named as Atikos COVID-19 Patients Care System, it interconnects patients and attendees wirelessly within 1 kilometer radius circles. More than 100 patients can be displayed on the monitor.
This is a digital solution which connects corona patients and also the doctors and nurses who are in the hospitals. This is a button. This button will be given to the patients in case of any emergency. They need to just press this button. What happens is if they press this button, there will be one nurse station, one small display in the nurse station. In that, they can get the patient's information like a patient name, room number, blood group, everything. And in that nurse station, we can able to show more than 100 patients in one monitor. That's the biggest advantage.
Amid COVID-19 pandemic, there are a number of innovators across the country who are coming up with different solutions to curb the virus spread.
Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. This quote goes well in the scenario of COVID-19 pandemic, when it is required for everyone to keep aside all their religious or other biases and come forward to serve the society. Several such examples that have made this code turn into reality can be witnessed across the nook and corner of our country. One among them can be found in Kozhikode district of Kerala, where a small committee of members has come to the rescue of those who have been quarantined. Take a look.
Staying quarantined can become really tough, especially if there is no one to look after your basic needs like food. But in Kulankara Thaza area of Kozhikode's Kuriyade village, quarantine seems to have become bliss for the people, as they are being provided with tasty meals for 3 times a day by the members of a relief committee in the area. The committee is not just preparing the meal but is also distributing at the doorstep the people who are in quarantine, no matter which caste or community they belong to.
हम लोग ये खाना क्वारंटाइन सेंटर में लेके जा रहे हैं। वो लोग अलग-अलग जगह में रहता है। इतना दिन चाहिए तो हम लोग देने के लिए खाना देने के लिए रेडी है। हम लोग अभी दिन में 3 दिन खाना देता है। Breakfast, lunch, dinner.
In Kulankara Thaza area, a total of 32 people are in quarantine. While 18 of them are in quarantine with their family, the other 14 are in Seoul quarantine. Almost all of these people have returned from the Gulf countries, and now, as they are back to their hometown, the relief committee is looking after all their food requirements so that they don't have to step out to buy the eatables. Proper hygiene is maintained while preparing and serving the food, and social distancing norms are also given due importance. A number of women from the area are also helping the relief committee in the preparation of food.
Siap dhanal relief, nyangalode quarantine lalkarku bhakshanam pakam cheythu kodukkan aavumo ennu chodichu. Angane nyangal poorna sammathathode adu etteduthu. Ippo
In these times of crisis, there are a number of people who have come forward to help the needy people, no matter which caste or community they belong to, and it's due to the efforts that India is able to cope well with this COVID-19 situation.
Media pundits who have been for the past few years chanting death knells for radio in India have now got their lips sealed, as this broadcast platform is not just standing alive but is still kicking and engaging huge audience across the country, successfully fighting off threats that it had to counter with the advent of cable TV and social media. Radio continues to evolve in the country. A glimpse of its popularity can be witnessed in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir, where people are seen turning towards radio to attain all the reliable information. Moreover, in this COVID-19 scenario, radio has turned out to be a boon for students by helping them in covering their syllabus.
Be it catching up to the latest trends, knowing what's going in the surroundings, or just grooving on the melodious tunes of famous voices, the radio does it all for the people of Jammu and Kashmir, who are mostly dependent on this broadcast platform. Even in this era of digital media, radio has not failed to catch the fancy of youngsters in the region. Muhammad Latif, a college student from the Darsu village of the Udhampur district, is a big radio listener. For getting all the daily updates or enhancing his knowledge, he only tuned into radio. While expressing his views, Latif said that radio is his main source of information and he has been listening to it for the last 8 years.
मैं जो है रोज रेडियो सुनता हूँ. रेडियो जो है एक गांव तक लोगों के जो जानकारी पहुँचाने का अच्छा माध्यम है. इससे जो है नौजवानों में जो स्कीमें चल रही हैं, जो बेरोजगार नौजवान हैं उन तक जो गवर्नमेंट की स्कीमें चल रही हैं वो पहुँचती है. जैसे हमारी देश के वज़ीर आज़म ने कुछ फ्लैगशिप जो कार्यक्रम हैं वो शुरू किए, जैसे स्वच्छ भारत अभियान है, बेटी बचाओ बेटी पढ़ाओ है. रेडियो से यही फायदा हुआ कि लोगों को, जो लोग खेती बाड़ी करते थे इनको भी लोगों से पता चला है कि कितना जमीन में खाद डालना है और जो खाद है वो भी देसी डालना है, इसमें जो है दूसरा खाद नहीं डालना है. और जो नौजवान है उन्हें पढ़ाई की जो अच्छी जानकारी मिलती है, जनरल नॉलेज मिलता है, न्यूज़ जो है लोग बच्चे जो नौजवान है वो सुनते रहते हैं. और हमें जो है रेडियो जरूर सुनना भी चाहिए.
Meanwhile, amid COVID-19 crisis, radio has turned out to be a savior for the students who were earlier finding it difficult to learn their lessons without any guidance. AIR Bhadarwa, which covers the entire Doda district, has started airing 1.5 hours of educational content daily since May 2019 on frequency 101 megahertz. This initiative of starting radio classes has been taken by the Jammu and Kashmir's Educational Department and has been benefiting over 45,000 students in the district. The students too are enjoying this new experience and have been religiously attending the classes every morning.
लगता है जो वीडियो जो रेडियो के थ्रू एजुकेशन पे जितना भी सारा कुछ आता है वो बहुत ज़्यादा बेनिफिशियल है फॉर दो स्टूडेंट्स हु आर नॉट कनेक्टेड टू स्कूल कोचिंग एंड ट्यूशंस. हाँ, इनफैक्ट दे नो ईच एंड एवरीथिंग अबाउट रेडियो. हाँ, जो रेडियो है ये पहले भी था, आज भी और हमेशा रहेगा.
द हिस्ट्री ऑफ रेडियो इन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर डेट्स बैक टू 1947 व्हेन द फर्स्ट रेडियो स्टेशन वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन द रीजन. It was known as Radio Kashmir and further Radio Kashmir Srinagar and Radio Kashmir Jammu. This nomenclature was however changed to All India Radio on the eve of withdrawal of the special status of Jammu and Kashmir on August 5, 2019.
Good morning world. Assalamu alaikum. Aadab. Namaste. Sat Sri Akal.
While AIR Jammu broadcast in Dogri, Urdu and Hindi, AIR Srinagar broadcast in Kashmiri, Urdu and Hindi. With time, radio listenership has only picked up pace in Jammu and Kashmir, and people say that it's only due to radio that they get to know about the benefits which the federal government is providing to them.
जितना भी गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से कोई भी इंफॉर्मेशन आती है तो वो रेडियो के ज़रिए से हम लोग सुनते हैं, तो इसी से हमें मालूम होता है कि गवर्नमेंट इंडिया से क्या क्या हमें फ़ायदा मिल रहा है.
नॉट जस्ट इन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर बट रेडियो हैज़ कंटिन्यू टू इवॉल्व अक्रॉस द कंट्री. इट हैज़ नॉट जस्ट अडेप्टेड टू द चेंजिंग टेस्ट बट हैज़ ऑल्सो प्लेड अ मेजर रोल इन ब्रिंगिंग पीपल टूगेदर, especially the Prime Minister radio program Mann Ki Baat.
that's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@ANIN.com. I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.